I feel like the hardest part of this is over for me. Like, from now, it's like I can finally, like, relax into the trip and just enjoy the stops. I think the first day was tough, just leaving and stuff. I mean, for me, something like a safety net, I always thought of it, like, being home. I always thought of it, like, financial, almost. You know, like, if your family's around, they kind of got you. But emotionally, you guys, like, in a lot of ways, were my ego. So it's like now, I always think of myself as a really confident person, and now it's like the true test, like, me by myself, like, standing on my own. That's the real safety net that I'm cutting here.
Like, took over and did my headshots over there, so it's just, like, nice to come back and kind of, like, reflect and where I started, where I'm going, how it started, how it's going, that kind of thing. So, yeah, I was, like, right in this section, maybe a little bit back, and read the lines, and then a little bit later, I was signed and had an agent.
It was a lot harder than I expected it. Well, I guess you would expect it. But when you're talking about making your life better and making adjustments to it and stuff, you think of cutting toxic people out of your life or distancing yourself from negative influences. But you never really consider what happens when that the people that you have to distance from in order to be happy are positive influences. You love people that, yeah, bring out the best in you. It's a huge sacrifice. So this trip, while it looks like great and I'm gonna enjoy every minute of it, make no mistake, this is like a really, really big sacrifice wrapped up in a California shape. But
Denver Day!
When I think about my career and things I'm making for it, it's like, I was telling you this earlier, but yeah, I was getting up, waking up at like 5 a.m. to make a call time before, or waking up in order to make it to a 5:30 a.m. call time, you know, like memorizing pages of dialogue, you know, like that's not really a sacrifice, you know, like that's the dream, that's like acting, that's what I sacrificed actually been doing. This is a sacrifice, having to reduce the physical presence that, like, my family and my support system has in my life. Like, that's where the real sacrifice is.
Giving it up in the service.
Yeah, and I wasn't as prepared. Like, I was prepared for the physical work ethic sacrifice, where you're like, I'm ready to get up at 5 a.m. Like, but that's pretty enjoyable for me the whole time. And you find that thing. This part is the hard part. I was hoping that the sadness that I felt for leaving and stuff and changing, the changes, like, opens up the way for me to be happier than, you know, reach new levels of happiness and enjoying stuff. So hopefully, it's all worth it. Yeah.
Small joys, I think it's awesome. I feel like even if you quit and you felt like in a month or whatever, it wasn't the right move, you decided to come home, like, that would be, like,
this season on Diary of a Bliss Junkie.
Mike will make.
I hate blackjack, I hate gambling, and it's a stupid thing.
I always wanted to fuck that bitch. Thank you God I fucked that bitch. I always wanted to live this life. I always wanted to wear that ice. I always wanted a paradise. I always want a paradise, look. Nah, it don't take a lot to make you rich. I'm addicted to a lot of crazy shit.
Shut, I feel like money is the best drug. Sometimes hate can be the best love.
Walking in like I got cameras on me. Niggas can't control me, ain't no handles on me. Shit don't get out of hand, it get handled, homie. Got a pretty young girl, look like Janet on me. She a pretty penny and she know I'm doing numbers till we crash up the whole database. I bring it home like I'm base to base. The base closet looking like Planet of the Bay, the next. What you think this life just landed on me? My whole city look like it's abandoned, homie. And we came straight out of those abandoned homies. Every wish we ever had got granted, homie. And I never take that shit for granted. Even when the marble flowing, kind of toppers are granted. Back before I got paid any advances. Back when my rollie was digging, no dancing. Niggas never did, I slip or I panic. Even if I was a captain of Titanic. Riding through the North Atlantic, homie. I never jump crew or abandoned, homie. All the fruits of my label organic, homie. Making sure my family tree got hammocks on it. And that good guy could change, especially if you short change. So fuck is my ransom, homie.
Money back, money back, money back.
Money back.
Money back, money
tumbleweed.
Back.
Tumbleweed! Yeah! I
missed
this. There's always tumbleweed!
Chicago is hell out here, like, getting excited. And brown cows. Cows in Nebraska are brown, guys.
Brown black. Black. Mostly black.
Chicago, we used to white cows with the cartoon-looking cows.
Right.
No matter what, like, even as long as it takes to have whatever levels of success I reach out there. That's the other cool thing about this is, like, you usually watch these things after the person is already on. So, like, you know that, like, they get on and they get successful and stuff. Like, y'all, you mo- we can bleep the cuss words, right? Because
that's what like, everybody.
Gonna be watching.
Yeah, but, like, this is, like, going to be, I could fall on my face out there, go out there and, like, and it would just really be, it's easy to talk about the stuff that we're talking about now after it's been successful, but like I'm talking, it's like, guys, I could be wrong.
You gotta
be wrong about these philosophies.
The universe.
We don't want to play out. But no matter what level of success I have out there in California or whatever, I'm already winning just because I'm enjoying it. Like the end goal is happiness more than it is. You have to just be enjoying myself. I want this to be like the moment that you look back and it's like, there, that's when everything changed. That's when, like, life really, really got good. I've never done anything like this before, solely selfishly in the literal definition of the term, where it's like just for myself, this is completely for me. So I want this to be like, that's the moment where life really, really started my, where it took control of my head. I did like a mini version of it when I took a trip to Paris with my friends for a month. And that was where I want that moment to be like my deciding. And this was the beginning of an execution. This is like the first day of the rest of my life. No way. Like, I like to use sports analogy, but so like, this is like the start of rookie season. My rookie season coming through. I feel like all the past stuff, Big Sean, this is
Big Sean college.
Yeah, all that stuff, all my old shit, that shit was practice. From here on out, it's murder. It's murder. Somebody was like, when they found out I was going to California, you know, they gave me things, like, they had the whole group like out there, like, keep, stay focused, don't get, like, get lost in the, you know, bad, like, nausea, whatever. And they were like, for the love of God, please don't get pregnant.